Hello everybody, I'm Lucia Luzzetti, I'm responsible of the emergency services and operation in Igeos, and I will show a new product generation for flood based on the integration of remote sensing and hydraulic modeling. Let me start with a picture that shows the percentage of occurrences of disaster by disaster types. The last United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction report confirmed how the last 20 years has seen the number of major floods more than double by comparison of previous 20 years, affecting about 1.65 billion of people worldwide. So in this global context, it's clear that it's necessary to use strong monitoring technologies that allow to follow the extreme events and provide all the information to assess and mitigate flood risk. A wide range of information can be generated by satellite remote sensing. We already seen some presentation, especially for flood, soil moisture analysis, historical flood footprint, estimation of precipitation intensity, and flood frequency. Starting from the experience collected as service provider of Copernicus EMS Rapid Mapping Service since 2012, Igeos started to work on a new generation of products for flood, integrating the information extracted from satellite image, especially SAR data due to the weather condition, and hydraulic modeling. This integration allows to provide a detailed flood information in urban area with associated flood depth data and the temporal evolution of the event. This is another key point of this new product. This new product is also the winner of the National Innovation Award, Premio dei Premi Cotec in Italy. Let me show and quickly describe the hybrid workflow that we identified. First of all, we use to connect the early warning system with the satellite component. So it means that when there is an alert, our emergency mapping room task immediately SAR data in order to acquire the first satellite images very close to the start of the flood event. And when we have the confirmation that the flood is ongoing, we start to prepare all the hydrological data that are useful for the hydraulic modeling. The integration of the standard remote sensing workflow, so the standard satellite product for flood and hydraulic model, is performed in the calibration phase. So it means that we run the hydraulic modeling and we calibrate the model according to the information that we have extracted from the SAR images. So it means that it is a dynamic modeling, especially when we work on ongoing flood, because it means that we change the parameter of the hydraulic modeling in order to improve the calibration phase every time that we have an additional satellite image available. The result of this new workflow is to provide continuous information not only about the flood extent, but also on depth, velocity, over time, and avic analytics. This is a very important part of this product because it allows to basically rebuild the whole evolution, the dynamic evolution of the flood. So it means that, especially over some specific area, especially for agricultural feed, for example, it's very relevant to know the flood persistency. or over urban area, it's very important to know the flood depth in order to have a first estimation of the damages over building, over infrastructure, and so on. Finally, this new workflow where the standard remote sensing is integrated with hydraulic modeling allow to improve the accuracy of the information that we are able to provide over urban area, over forested area. You know that when there is a flood, we use especially SAR data, and we know very well the limitation of this technique over, especially over urban area. Here, there is an example of the output that we are able to. Oh, sorry. Let me come back. This is an example of the output that we are able now to generate in our emergency services thanks to the integration of the hydraulic modeling. We are in Japan. This is a past flood event over Ibaraki. And the hydraulic model, you can see that allow to have at the end a multi-temporal product, okay? This is very important because you know that the satellite component has some limitation. We cannot decide when we want to collect the best picture of the flood, very in general, very close to the peak, no? But we have some constraint. We have to collect information when the satellite pass over the affected area. So it means that the SAR acquisition allow to improve the information that comes from the hydraulic modeling because we perform the calibration based on the flood extent extracted from the SAR images. And at the end, we are able to provide the civil protection or other user with a multi-temporal product with the flood extent and the flood depth. Finally, the last step of this new workflow and the new product generation for flood foresee the validation that in general we perform with the social media data because social media data are the first information available when there is an event. We are service provider of several emergency services that are worldwide. So it means that not always we have available in situ data or precise information that comes from the field. But the integration of social media marker allow us to perform at the end a validation with a comparison of the depth that we extract from the hydraulic modeling with the information that comes from the, especially the picture available online.
And, sorry, you have 2 minutes.
Yes, I'm going to complete. Thank you. And in this picture, it's very clear how we work with social media. This is the flood of the Hurricane Harvey in Houston, where we worked with the integration of SAR data, and we rebuild the whole event with hydraulic modeling. In this case, there were a lot of information available online, and we used all this picture to perform a validation. And this new generation of product for flood is part also of the new product portfolio of the Copernicus EMS Risk and Recovery Mapping Service. So this is an operational workflow that we are providing also for Copernicus EMS Risk and Recovery Mapping Service. I have completed my presentation. I know in advance that I was the last, so I try to go fast.